Welcome back to another Dark Vision in FFBE. So this is Dark Vision 10, which is equal to Dark Vision 12 on JP server. If you want monster data reference, you can go to Dark Vision 12 on Reddit. Okay, let's start with the first area. So this area is a magical domain of water and light. Boss is demon type monster.Because we use Terra here, we can ignore those element and monster types. Another thing that I need to mention here is Terra still does damage overflow. You need to unequip her gear, and I'm gonna show you later in the video. For this area, all of the attacks are physical attacks, which you can ignore all of those attacks with physical cover tank.You don't even need 100% provoke and evasion tank. Physical cover is enough to deal with this stage. If you're not gonna use physical cover tank, you can also use elemental resistance. On the stage 1 in this area, boss does lightning damage. On the stage 2, boss does dark and lightning damage, so you need 100% resistance on those elements after buff. But physical cover tank is easier.Okay, let's start with the first unit, Master Myson. He don't need to gear for provoke and evasion tank, but I also have his gear right there. The only thing he need here is elemental weapon, because nobody can imbue him in this team, so he need to equip with elemental weapon. Any element is fine.Fawn will be a breaker and AR channel with Master Myson. There are two things that he needs. First, he needs to dual wield, because his AR channeling move not included in his dual cast and triple cast, so you need to dual wield him to proc it twice. And second, you need to equip him with elemental weapon nobody is gonna imbue him to. Gaban will be a physical cover tank. You don't need Gaban.You need someone that able to use a physical cover and able to build 100% evasion. Another thing that you need on physical cover tank is confuse resistance. But I'm not really sure that this is a threshold attack or a normal attack. Terra will be a solo damage dealer here. She gonna be a burst damage with her limit burst. Her normal form don't have anything, and her brave form, I equip her with her STMR. That's the only thing she need to be a solo damage dealer without chaining cap. Alright, let's start the fight.Okay, start with Wan, use his limit burst to break and decrease 130% fire elemental resistance. Gaban use his physical cover skill. Terra shift to her breath form. Magitek power release fire and... the bug again. Magitek power release fire and trash burst.As you can see here, all of those attacks are physical, so Gaban can evade all of them. Alright, we got Gaban here. Master Myson and Wan use AR chaining move. Send them first. That is for 100 chain score.And Terra for cap damage. Okay, that is the first stage in this area. Move to the next stage. Okay, for the second stage in this area. This is my second time in this area. Because on the first time, I think Terra able to cap damage by herself. But for real, she unable to do that. So I need to do some adjustment that I give her the second weapon to activate six shining cap when dual wielding. Bot is tankier than I thought. Even fit in her limit burst into AR chain. The other thing is same as usual. Mastermind gonna need an elemental weapon. That's all he needs here. Farn will be a breaker and give him dual wield with elemental weapon. Kaban will be a physical cover tank with 100% evasion. And for Terra, you need to dual wield her. Because I equip her with her SCMR and she unable to cap. Even I fit in her limit burst into AR chain. So dual wielding make her able to reach 6 chaining cap. So it's gonna increase her damage a little bit and that enough to cap in this stage. Okay, let's start. We gonna use same strategy as stage 1. Farn use his limit burst to break and decrease fire resistance. Kaban use his cover. And Terra shift to her bare form. Use Magitek power release fire and trance burst. This stage is the same as the first one. All the attacks from boss are physical attacks, so you don't need any elemental resistance if you have physical cover tank. Alright, on turn 2, guard Kaban. And dual cast AR Shining move from Van and Mastermind Zone. Okay, this time we're gonna fit in Terra Limit Burst into AR Chain. Start with Terra. 1, 2, 3, click AR chain. Okay, that is the max score for stage 1 and 2 in area 1. Move to the area 2, which is a physical domain. Okay, move forward to the area 2. So this area is a physical domain of ice and earth. Boss is aquatic type monster. As usual, this stage is not that hard. As you can see on the screen, Tifa is the only damage dealer here, so she can cap this stage by herself. You don't even need somebody to buff killer to her. Nobody on screen able to buff aquatic killer. There's something that I need to mention before going into the fight. This stage is quite biased to Shoreline, Fina and Daisy. Because most of the boss attack are magic damage. So she is a magical cover tank. She's gonna consume all of that damage. But boss still have single target physical attack, so you need someone to do physical evasion and provoke tank. Not only that, Faithy able to do earth imbue and impel, which is a direct element for this stage. Another thing is if you don't use magic cover tank, you can use elemental resistance buff. On stage 1, boss does 5 elemental attack, so you need 100% fire resistance after buff. On stage 2, boss start fire and wind attack. So you need 100% on fire and wind resistance after buff. But slot in magic cover tank is better so you can ignore all of those resistance. Alright, let's start with the first unit. Farn will be a breaker and chaining AR for 100 chain score. The only thing he needs here is dual wielding. You don't need elemental weapon here because Faithy had AoE earned in build. Mastermind Sword will be a physical evasion and provoke tank. He also don't need any elemental weapon here. So he gonna take benefit from that AoE earned in build. Sylvie will be 300% attack buff on Tifa. Because Tifa use off element, she unable to access to her attack buff. You need somebody to buff her attack and Sylvie gonna do that. And that is the only thing she does. Cholyphena and Daisy will be magic cover tank, earth imbue and impeller. We gonna use her in bear form only, so you don't need to gear her on normal form. The most important thing here is you need 100% or more for fire and wind. If you, I'm not sure turn 4 or turn 5, boss gonna impeller you with 50% fire and wind. So you can build a 150% or more for that situation. But if you do 2 turn kill, 100% is enough for fire and wind resistance. Her gear is focused on those, you don't need HP or spirit because we're not gonna take any single damage here. Tifa will be a limit burst finisher and carry over the 2.1 damage. On her normal form, I equip her with some limit fill gear. Call of the Wild is the best here because it fills your unit with egg limit crystal at the very beginning of the battle. Top up with Faithy limit fill, so it's enough to fill Tifa limit gauge. But if you don't have it, you need someone to fill Tifa limit gauge because she unable to fill it by herself. Or you're gonna need some luck for generate limit crystal for monster. On her bear form, gear her for limit burst damage, aquatic killer and her attack. So with this build, she had 300% on aquatic killer and limit burst damage. Okay, let's go. Alright, start with Fan, use his limit burst to break boss. So we gonna buff attack, so let's triple cat here. Marian's watch over me to buff attack, and we gonna use 300% attack buff to Tifa. The rest can be anything. Let's imbue her with earth element. Faithy gonna shift to her bear form and dual cast. First one gonna be healing ripple to fill limit gauge. Bug again. First cast is healing ripple to fill limit gauge. The second one is beast fat for earth imbue and imperil. Tifa shift to her bear form after fill limit gauge. Use awakened fighting spirit. Mastermind spawn guard here. As you can see here, boss still has single target physical attack, so you need physical evasion and provoke tank. Alright, Sylvie and Faithy gonna guard because we don't want them to mess up our chain. Juan and Mastermind Thorn use their AR chaining move. And Tifa use her limit burst. Send AR first. Wait after 30 chain, send Tifa. That is 2.14 by herself. Okay, easy peasy for the first stage. Move to second stage in this area. Okay. This is a long take, so I'm not gonna cut anything here. Alright, for the second state in this area, Dark Leviathan. Same as usual, same strategy, same equipment here. For one, you need to dual wield him only, you don't need elemental weapon. Mastermind Sword is a physical evasion and provoke tank. You also don't need elemental weapon like one.Sylvie will be a buffer and she don't need any equipment on her. Faithy will be a magic cover tank. We're gonna use her in wave form only, so gear her with 100% or more for fire and wind resistance. Tifa will be a limit burst finisher. Don't forget to slot in Call of the Wild for egg limit crystal fill. And her bear form gear her with limit burst damage, aquatic killer, and her attack. She has 300% on both limit burst damage and aquatic killer. Okay, let's go. Because we use fire and wind resistance,We don't need to adjust our gear in this stage. Start with one, use his limit burst to break. So we gonna triple cat and buff attack for her ally and Tifa. Faithy shift to her bear form. Healing ripple on first cat to fill limit gauge. And beach flag on the second cat to imbue Imperial Earth.Guard Thorn. Shift Tifa to her bear form and use Awakened Fighting Spirit. This stage is the same as the first stage. Boss only attack you with magic damage, but it also has some single target physical attack. Okay, on the second turn, guard Faithy and Sylvie. Mastermind Thorn and Wan use their AR Chaining move.Tifa use her limit burst. Send AR first. Wait for 30 chain and send Tifa. Okay, 2.14 by herself. If you're unable to cap with Tifa, you can slot in a finisher in the free slot. It's not that hard for the first day of Dark Vision. Alright, that's all for today. Thanks for watching and... Bye.